Well, in those far off days, my mother always said, we might be poor, but we're lucky in love. Eh? Because my dad, very passionate. Oh, we'd follow her everywhere. She couldn't even do a spot of low dusting. He'd chase her up the stairs, make mad passionate love to her. And then when they came downstairs, everybody on the bus applauded. And the daft things that my mum used to say. She'd say, don't look now, but look who's behind us. If you break your leg, don't come running to me. Shut your mouth and eat your dinner. But she used to. And my sister, she went to the doctors, very flat chested. Corn plasters to draw out. And she went to the doctor, she said, I would like one of those transplants. He says, transplant? He says, you want more than a transplant? He says, you'll have to have a pump. She says, a pump? He says, yes. He says, and when you go to that 1940s dance at Lytham St. Anne's, he says, you get your pump, and you put it on your arm, and you go, thump, instant Dolly Parton. And there's a fella at the dance, he keeps staring at her like that. He said, excuse me, he said, don't I know you? She said, I don't think you do. He says, yes, he says, but we've got the same doctor. And my auntie, well, we had no transport, did we? No transport, we used to go to work on our bike. Do you remember that? One day, my uncle came back from work for his dinner, and my auntie stood on the doorstep, the biggest pair of bazookas he'd ever seen in his life. He said, where'd you get them? She said, well, she said, that gypsy came round, and he gave me a magic mirror, and I put it on the door. And I said, mirror, mirror on the door, make my bust of 54. Well, he looked at that mirror. He said, hickory dickory dock. And the wheels fell off his bike, you're right. And my dad weren't very good at all that DIY. That destroy yourself. And one day, my mother, she says to him, oi, useless. He said, yes, because he knew his name. And she said, fix that electric light. He says, electric light. He says, do I have electrician written on my head? She said, suit yourself. She said, fix that leaking pump. He says, leaking pump. He says, do I have plumber written on my head? She said, suit yourself. 3 days later, he came home from work and all the jobs are done. She said, how do you get the jobs done? He said to her. She said, well, she says, your friend came round from Knot End. And he said he'd fix all the jobs if I either paid him in kind or baked him a cake. He said, which flavour cake did you bake him? She said, do I have Mary Berry written on? But meanwhile, on a street somewhere in Lancashire. To top of work. And I fell off at Lytham. And before they were liked, our Ethel got open, our Ronnie got open, our Tommy got open, our Jack got open, our Bernice got open, our Peter and our Paul and our Trevor and our Elaine and our Clive and our Sarah and our Ashley and our Elliot and our Billy and our Forrest. And I thought, hey, it's nice to have the bench yourself. my old grander, he was the worst one. He only got married to a 23-year-old woman. I said, "Grandad," I said, "don't you realise that could be fatal?" He says, "Well, if she dies, she dies." And they came home, they started making love to the sound of the church bells. It was all right till the fire engine went past. And he went to the doctor, he said, "Doctor," he said, "please help me," he said, "I need something to keep me nice and amorous with the wife." And the doctor said, "What do you want to do? You want to start eating plenty of brown bread." So he's up the baker's shop like a rat up a drain pipe. He says, "Give me £5 worth of brown bread." The baker said, "It'll go as hard as a rock." He says, "Give us a tenner's worth." There's a woman there writing it down. And she's doing that to her husband, right? Then the doctor came flying out of the insulting room. And he saw three women sat on the chairs with the daughters. And he said to the first one, he says, "I don't know why you're here." He says, "You think about nothing but drinking. You even called your daughter Sherry." And the second one, he says, "And you," he says, "you think about nothing but smoking. You called your daughter Virginia." The third one said, "Come on, Fanny, we're not stopping here to be insulted." And that Sunday morning, my granddaddy says to me, "Grandma," he says, "come on," he says, "come on, Bertha," he says. He said, "Let's have a little walk in the park." "Oh," she said. She said, "Walking in the park?" She said, "What with my complaint, I don't want to be walking park. I don't want to be walking in the park." He says, "Come on, it'll do you good." He says, "It's a big day for you tomorrow. You're having your feet done." "Oh," she says, "well, all right, then I'll come with you." He says, "Come on," he says, "we'll go on the swings." He says, "But look over there," he says. He says, "Look at the fence," he says. "That's the fence where we made mad passionate love 40 years ago. He said, "Do you fancy doing it again?" "Oh," she says, "I don't mind if I do," she says. And he made mad passionate love against the fence. "Oh," he said, "that was better than 40 years ago." She said, "The fence wasn't electrified 40 years ago." They were grand in them good old days. Ladies and gentlemen, they always say it's nice to be important, but it's far more important to be nice, and you've been nice to me. So long, been good to know you. So long, been good to know you. So long, been good to know you. So I've got a big written love. So I say, thank you, been great to be here, thank you, been great to be here, thank you, been great to be here, I've got a new written love. Before I hit the track, don't forget to tell them I'm off, isn't back, and so long, sunny sentence, so long.